But after INTZPEDG, we know that anything actually can happen. Will it happen? Who knows? But this is a very exciting world and a great day one.
Well, taking a quick look at the bans, Kassadin, Aurelion Sol, and Karma all taken off the table. Senkaks was one of the early adopters of some of those new age mid lane picks, and obviously a Sol being one of those Nidalee Elise. Off the table, jungle picks definitely the priority. And I want to see what Trash is going to play. He played a lot of Gragas in summer, was a phenomenal Gragas. We're not expecting to see that really much this Worlds.
But heavy targeting of Senkaks coming out here. I mean, he already had a poor laning phase. He's down roughly 4 CS at 10 minutes in the regular season. That only got worse going into playoffs. In fact, it doubled. He was down roughly 8 CS at 10 minutes. And Crown, on the other hand, has got some of the best CS differentials in the tournament.
And he's been going up against the level of competition in the LCK against mid laners like Faker. So very touted player in the mid lane is Crown. I like the Syndra ban to try and control this. It's one of the strongest mid laners. We saw INTZ first picking it, and it's one of the things you would pick if you definitely want to focus the mid lane. So really just trying to get Senkaks onto a late game scaling mage, and I think they've done that with the early Cassiopeia pick.
They certainly have, and the other thing they've done is kind of secure their 1-3-1, because now all of a sudden, if Senkaks does go to a side lane, they are able to get Mikey as well as someone else like a Trashy down into that lane and help if they do try and set up a roaming gank squad to deal with it. So I like the two first picks so far from Splice. Tahm Kench is a very important pick for this team.
I'm very surprised we hadn't seen more Tahm Kench to this point today. We're already in the fifth game. And I think it's spectacular from a map pressure perspective. If they can get any type of advantage in the bottom lane, it gives many roaming opportunities for them.
Let's see if Splice can get those opportunities to pull ahead. Samsung Galaxy have locked in Rumble and Ezreal. Definitely going to keep people at arm's length if they need to or want to with Equalizer and all of the poke. But locking in that top laner allows Wonder to counterpick.
Certainly does. However, Kube has been known as a mage player. I mean, he plays a lot of Maokai, as all top laners do. But when you look down the rest of his champion pool, has been favored on the likes of the Lissandra and the likes of Rumble. So good to see that he's going back to comfort in game one.
I think Rumble and Kennen are his two most lethal picks here at the World Championship. They obviously decided to target other things, so he gets the Rumble. Jinx pick is a little bit risky, but they do have it locked in with the Tahm Kench, so they're hoping to get it to the teamfight phase and take advantage of some of the scaling.
And Ezreal typically doesn't win lanes unless it's paired with something like Anami, which we've just seen. Mm-hmm. However, if they're able to neutralize this here, Kobe as well as Mickey, then they just have such good late-game scaling coming into these teamfights.
And here's the interesting thing as well. Wraith is back in for Samsung. When they made their regional qualifier run, they'd switched in Core JJ, who was more of a roaming support. They're expecting to be able to win the lane in this matchup, although in the regular season, they mainly played the duo lane to split. So this is a diversion from their normal playstyle, picking so heavily towards trying to win that lane with the Ezreal and the Nami.
And it's the first time that we're seeing Kobe on the Jinx, so it's going to be a difference in playstyle for Samsung Galaxy. First time seeing that Jinx for Kobe at least this year.
The last thing I will say about the Jinx is it's a Hurricane first user, so it makes sense for Splice. You can get it into that mid lane. It clears out minion waves incredibly effectively if they do want to try and break up that map. However, Crown has locked in his most famous champion in that Victor.
Yeah, during the regular season, he played three times as many Victor games as his next most played champion. And the last time this guy played Victor was against KT Rolster in game one. He went 12-0-4 and never got to play it again for the rest of the series because it was banned in games two and three. Very comfortable champion there for Crown, and Samsung is looking like they're just trying to play a lot of wave clear.
The one thing I am seeing as a fear for Splice is the fact that there's a lot of AoE damage on the side of Samsung Galaxy and two very low mobility, very squishy carries sitting on the back line. Tahm Kench can only save one of them. Are we going to see the Cantankerous Cavalier or not, Spawn? What do you think?
Well, one thing that Mickey has actually done is shown a couple of mid laners, and of course, Wonder has played a few games of Cassiopeia top.
Do it! Is it going to happen?
Yes! Gonna happen?
It's going to happen! Kled! He's locked in!
One thing that we have seen as a bit of an early trend at Worlds is a lack of engage from a lot of these teams because there's a lot of poke-focused champions. Someone who can remedy that would be a Kled.
Yeah, it certainly is. And another thing to point out with all these AP top laners being picked so early in the draft, Kled does so well against them in the laning phase. You need the AD, but going things like the Hexdrinker into Black Cleaver just allows you to tank up at the same time.
Taking a step back and looking at Splice's strengths, Wonder has been the rock that Splice have relied on time and time again. And if Wonder shows up here today, it could be how Europe pick up their first victory at the World Championship on a first time competitive CLED in 2016 Worlds.
Yeah, this is going to be a somewhat CLED-focused game, but also it's the first time we're seeing these teams in general. So there are so many new variables to try to account for on top of the pressure of the world stage. Also, after witnessing EDG losing to INTZ, like, these guys need to keep their nerves completely under control because it's about to get crazy here.
What do we expect then from this early game in terms of all of the jungle pressure and where we're going to see it focus? Is there going to be relief for that Jinx TK down bottom, if at all? Or will it be focused on Wonder up top? Spawn, what do you think?
I actually have been very impressed by Trashy's pathing towards the top side of the map, in saying that when you go up against a jungler that is as experienced as Ambition, you have to expect that the counter ganks are coming. And with very low CC coming out of the jungler, we've already seen it once, Graves does struggle.
Well, for the first time here in San Francisco, we will see the Cantankerous Cavalier cleared in the hands of Wonder, going up against Cube and Samsung Galaxy. Second last game of the day, and I can't wait to see how these teams get ahead, because it feels like both team compositions, when ahead, can easily continue to push that lead and push that advantage.
I definitely agree on that point. However, the CLED has got me slightly perplexed, because not only is he great engage for himself, but he speeds up your secondary engage, and that is generally something I've seen a lot of CLED Skarner running around in solo queue. Kobe likes to talk about that a lot. However, there's no one really to chase Wonder into this team fight. It's just going to be a heck of a lot of damage running in behind him, so his ultimates have to be very calculated.
Exactly. The damage comes in behind him, but doesn't actually want to go in with him. All three of those champions want to keep their distance from the team fight, so it creates a mismatch situation, so to speak, which kind of makes me think that Splice is really wanting this matchup between CLED and the Rumble. Because he can build Hexdrinker and because he can threaten QV with damage, I'm thinking they're trying to snowball him ahead from a laning perspective, because as far as other teams would go, this is less reliant on getting an all-in CLED ultimate engage.
100%. But the other thing about CLED is the one weakness in his kit right now is he gets pushed in early. And when we did change Rumble to do maximum damage against those creeps, he is a very good early pusher. Does that open the window for Trashy? Sure, but Wonder should be under his turret the majority of this early game.
And that speaks to some of the trends we've seen so far at Worlds. In only four games so far, we've seen three level three turret dives from the jungler pathing up. I'm very curious to see if Ambition does a modified route so that he could potentially arrive top lane and try and kill Wonder, depending on the amount of poke the QV can get on him in lane.
And tracking those jungler decision-making, both starting around their respective blue buffs. However, Ambition not gone to the Sentinel just yet. And taking a look at, of course, how Wonder's handling himself, not pushed it just yet as Trashy's on the Sentinel.
This is the biggest thing. Trashy solo started bottom side of the map, so he will have a gank path to the top lane. As I said, watch Trashy's pathing. He is one of the best pathing junglers, I think, in this tournament. Graves jungles incredibly quickly, incredibly healthy, and he should be able to beat the Rek'Sai back top.
Oftentimes, you expect the Graves to start in the top lane, and we've seen so much Scuttle Crab control, especially when you look at Samsung Galaxy's lane of Ezreal and Nami wanting to push up against a Jinx Tahm Kench. This is the risk of him pathing there.
Ruler, Arcane shifts forward, Exhaust trade back and forth. Cobby's down to 200, and Mickey dropped to about 100. But that's what you expect from this lane.
Yeah, Splice's lane really didn't want that to happen because they do not have a jungler to bail them out of this lane anytime soon. So a really unfortunate trade for them to take that early.
Yeah, it certainly is. The other thing, Tahm Kench gets very tanky at level two when you take that gray health. However, at level one is
Don't have any health to turn gray.
Yep, exactly right.
Wonder trying to trade out, riding Skull for the time being. Didn't really connect with that bear trap on a rope. One of my favorite spell names in the entire game. And Wonder's going to continue now, trying to deal with this wave. As expected, pushed in. Trashy did not go up for that sort of 320 early gank just yet, but is moving up to the Scuttle Crab. Places a ward that'll give some additional information to Senkux in the mid lane. And Senkux is actually shoving out quite heavily as well.
And with the invade on the bottom lane, you can see Nami going into place a ward. That kind of gives away where Trashy is on the map right now, because that's the timing that he normally would be on his blue. Instead, he's trying to invade Ambition.
Exactly. So even though they didn't directly see the vision, they kind of know where everyone is right now. They can expect the Graves to be at the blue buff. That's actually why QV had gone deep and placed that ward in the river. Trashy doesn't have a very clean way of ganking this anymore, and Ambition is trying to catch him out.
One more time. Ambition is a very intelligent jungler in his own right. You can see that he heads straight into that top side of the map. Big trades in the mid lane.
Oh, really? Big gravity field's going to stun Senkux. just on the edge, couldn't get the tail out, but Crown runs out of mana and cooldowns, and Senkux lives to slither away.
Yeah, it should be enough gold for him to recall and get a tier. And he's actually up in CS, but that's just because he's crashing the wave into the turret. I don't think that'll be that big of a deal for Senkux outside of losing his ghost.
And this is the second time we've had to see a Graves just walk into mid lane to rescue a minion wave and shove it into turret to get an early back. It also gives away Trashy's positioning, so Splice, for the time being, have to play very much on the back foot.
Well, that's something that Splice are actually going to be very used to. They're a team that traditionally has been very slow and struggled in the early game, and now there's pressure top.
This is such a long setup to this play. Because they saw Trashy killing Gromp, they know this is a clean gank, and they have Wunder low. They do have to worry about the dismount, and Wunder's got to get out of here.
He's starting to recall. Should be able to finish this one off. Ambition hasn't fired out the Prey Seeker. Oh, Wunder decides to cancel it. The minion wave is up.
Here are the minions.
Five minions remaining, 4-3, and Ambition still hasn't pulled the trigger. Kyubey's going to get out of range of that tether. And Wunder still survives. Ambition using that.
Trashy's got to get up there. Like the telegraphing on this gank should be there.
They're trying to get him off Skull because he does go invulnerable when he dismounts. However, this has taken such a long time.
One more
Trashy
hit.
Trashy is going to be there in time, it looks like it.
Crazy
gonna be really close.
Skull is sent
driving.
Wunder's in trouble. He's going to jump backwards with the rocket pistol. A lot of damage goes down. Trashy throws out end of the line. First blood to Samsung Galaxy.
And all of a sudden, Trashy's happy feeding in the top side of the jungle really does cost Splice because Wunder falls down and Trashy was just seconds too late.
Yeah, I think if they were to look at that in VOD review, as soon as Wunder got hit by the Q from the Rek'Sai out of the brush to interrupt his recall, he should have teleported away because that's the only way he's going to avoid giving up first blood since Trashy was so far away. But they thought they could make it there in time. They weren't quite there. And now there's some fighting in the bottom side.
Nikki's in so much trouble. Grey health has been popped. Decent flame chompers. But Ruler just arcane shifts forward. Flash for flash. Oh, Gardle! Cobby's down! Ruler and Wraith, they 2v2 Cobby and Mickey.
And this is one thing that Papa Smithy loves to talk about, how much better mechanically Wraith is than Core JJ, and he's able to get into that bottom lane and set up a 2v2 kill.
And the early laning phase from the Jinx Tahm Kench is not as good as the Ezreal or the Nami, so you have to wonder what Splice is really planning here. Trashy's path to try and give assistance to the top side, but that has failed because Ambition was able to get first blood. That means Kabe and Mickey have been on their own in that bottom side. They also die, and it's going pretty wrong for Splice at this moment.
It is. Trades now in the river. Trashy level 6 to Kyubey's level 6 as well. Mickey just over-eager, literally biting off more than Tahm Kench could chew. Unfortunately costs them. So top lane in favor of Kyubey, bottom lane in favor of Ruler and Wraith, and Samsung Galaxy, they've got a 1,000 gold lead at 7 minutes already.
And until then, that bottom lane was going so fine. I mean, they could have backed away. After the first recall, Jinx actually doesn't have any problem pushing out the lane with the rockets and the additional range she has over the Ezreal. A little bit greedy one more time for minion wave positioning, perhaps for Splice, and they do get punished quite heavily.
We'll find out what Splice can do. As we mentioned, this is a team that has been behind at the 10 and 20 minute mark several times in the summer split, but actually has found a way to bounce back.
Yes.
Pretty good win-loss ratio despite a pretty weak early game.
Exactly. A lot of times, even when they're losing in the early game, they're still able to pick up a lot of wins, which is incredibly uncommon. Even if you look at a team like Samsung, when Samsung falls behind, they lose most of their games. But contrary to that, when Samsung's winning, they win most of their games. They're actually incredibly consistent in that matter. So it's going to be tricky for Splice to be able to manage that in the game. I really expect a lot of Samsung's games in this tournament to be decided in the early game, and they're executing quite well throughout the first 8 minutes.
You have to feel it's going to be so reliant on this exact ability. Charge
right
from Wunder was...
Made it back in the lane. All right.
Just to get in there. I did see Trashy coming up from the river, so... Parding slash optimistic. But that's the ability that could be game-changing for Splice.
They needed the play because realistically right now, Ambition has complete control over the bottom side of the map. The 2v2 is losing, so if they can't rescue Wunder somehow, it's going to be incredibly difficult.
Speaking of control, no flash or heal, just the exhaust on Mickey.
Cobby's running for his life. Mickey decides to turn back to the tower. It's a 3-on-1 tower dive. Decent enough roof, but Ambition's out of the tower. Grey health comes up. Wraith is going low. Where's the support from Splice? Ruler, Truthshot Mirage gets the kill, but Cobby, he gets excited. That's a double kill for Senkux. That's one for Cobby. Splice, they've turned it around, and they've punish the dive. Wonder's going toe-to-toe with Q-Fate. Equalizer comes up. Flame Spitter's burning him down, and Skarl goes running. Wonder's able to hop away with the help of that rocket pistol.
And one thing I always love to see out of the European mid laners is the willingness to burn summoner spells to get to engages. Sand clicks that time, he burns the ghost, flashes over the wall, and saves the pretty dreadful situation.
Yeah, Mickey dodged just enough skill shots. Kabe stayed just close enough in range to be able to damage them while they were diving. And they made that dive look atrocious. For all that we just talked about Samsung being consistent and staying in the early game, they threw that lead away just now and splices right back into it.
Yeah, even out that gold lead, kills on Senkux's Cassiopeia and Kabe's Jinx. Also, we're approaching 10 minutes and Senkux isn't behind in CSD. I want to talk about that in a minute. Here's a replay of that dive.
We'll do it right after this. This was Ambition shooting way too far on his initial tunnel.
But look, this is where the summoner spell goes burnt right now. He's only halfway up river, and then all of a sudden comes out a Fog of War willing to flash the wall and set up a brilliant play. Really credit to Sandcox there to be able to get the maximum back for his team.
Yeah, and then they also get the kill for Kabe over the wall, which keeps him at least alive in this lane. Love Sengoku's up against Crown in this matchup. There's a lot of expectations coming against him into this tournament, but not only does he roam first, he doesn't lose his turret for it. He's now 2-0, able to itemize some magic resist early, and is set up for success.
And whilst not giving the young man excuses, he does pick for the team a lot in the European LCS. There's multiple Kassadin picks in there that do hurt the statistics. Yeah. Although he does have a tendency to fall behind on things like LeBlanc that do have lane control. but definitely showing that when he is focused and in the right matchup, he can go with the best of them.
That's the thing, Senkux isn't really the carry of the team. You know, he does his role, he cleans up later. It is a lot more about Wonder, Trashy, and Kabe. And it's up to Wonder to try bounce back. He's still down 10 CS, down an assist. Cuvée has got himself the Sork Shoes, as well as that Arm Guard. And Cuvée's the guy who really carried Samsung Galaxy to Worlds. You know, his regional qualified performance was phenomenal.
He got a bunch of solo kills onto Someday. Some would argue that Someday was playing a little bit loose and giving those solo kills away because for the most part, Cuvée had been a very neutral top laner who punishes mistakes but doesn't necessarily make huge plays on his own. And it's kind of how he's performing here. Decent start, got the one assist, itemizing with the Seeker's Arm Guard first to try and prevent Wonder from going off on Kled. And really, looks like he's moving down a little bit now to maybe get some type of Dragon play or gank mid.
A lot of potential in the mid, actually. Senkux is in trouble. No flash, remember.
Yeah.
Avenue Field comes up. Very good equalizer. That'll cut off at least one of the paths.
Beautiful!
Such a great sidestep! Cuvée does not look Cassiopeia in the eyes.
Cuvée played that amazingly. Able to get the Duke in there. Does not get tagged up by the ultimate. And that's a great roam. This is one thing that you have to respect about Rumble now. He shoved lane so hard that he is able to visit other areas of the map before the rest of your team can.
Now, Wonder's actually thinking about trying to get something back. This would be a time to charge.
And he's charging
into trouble.
There's a lot more support for Samsung Galaxy. Wonder dives back with Trash. He's forced to flash away, gets caught out. Teleport from Cuvée. Wonder's going to follow. A double kill for Crown. And here comes Mickey. He used the Voyage in, and now he's in trouble. Ambition's looking for more. No flash, good flame chompers. Kabe saves Mickey's life, but two members have spliced down.
That's the thing about Kled, when you charge, there's no undo button. You're going in, and that was a complete fail as far as Wonder with how many people he jumped into. Crown completely gets it back. That's the 2-0 victor. Good control and patience during that entire engagement. Samsung's back in control.
And this is what pressure does. I mean, all of a sudden, Cuvée with a great roam. Wonder wants to match it. He charges in, but there are three members, two waiting just outside of Fog of War, and the teleport to follow. Trashy, slight mechanical error, actually shoots himself back into the team. That means two members fall down.
Yeah, and I also like the fact that Samsung was focusing Trashy first, knowing Wonder's going to be jumping in with the big shield. So they get rid of Trashy. They know Wonder's put himself in a negative position, and they have a huge numbers advantage, and they quickly pick up both kills.
Samsung once again regain control. We're approaching 15 minutes. There's actually been a lot of action in this game.
And uncharacteristic action, honestly, from Splash. You don't expect them to play the early game this fast and lose. Generally, they would just give away that one kill onto Sandcooks. They would just try and farm out the mid lane with Trashy. Instead, they are overcommitting to these players, and it's not how we're used to seeing the team play.
And they really didn't have to. The whole way that Sengkooks died to that initial gank from Kyubey is because he was trying a very aggressive trade onto Crown. It's a Victor versus Cassiopeia matchup. If you want to let Victor shove into the wave, you're not going to miss any CS under the turret as the Cassiopeia. He was already even and he already had a kill advantage, so he could have extended that towards 25 minutes and been completely fine. But I do think they got a little bit greedy, maybe got confident because of the kill's bottom, and it's cost.
And you have to look at the trickle effect, because all of a sudden, Mickey, who had to voyage into that mid lane, has lost all control over the bottom lane. They got a bad back timing. First turret does fall down, and now the gold lane is extending.
Oh, Wonder's got good damage under QV. Skull's going to get popped, though. He uses that rocket pistol backwards. Wonder still running for his life. And just to sort of round out that conversation, Splice, their primary initiator is traditionally trashy. The other players have now had to learn how to initiate without Trashy being on that tanky front line. Trashy and Sengkooks, they're looking for Crown. Very good gravity field. That will at least stun up Trashy. Collateral damage goes backwards. And Sengkooks as well as Trashy, they force Crown away. It's a slightly messy engage around the dragon, but Samsung still have control of the Scuttle Crab. It looks like they're killing it and Vision in the pits.
They're really getting control all over the map. Kyubey's been able to shove out Wonder. I'm very surprised Wonder didn't go Hexdrain for any magic resist early, so he's actually losing these trades straight up. And because they're already at a deficit since they didn't kill Crown and really not even get a summoner spell out of them, they've lost control of the Dragon Pit as well.
And let's have a look at what that control of Dragon Pit did. Drag Trashy down, all of a sudden he can't gank the top lane. Kyubey, who's already winning that 1v1, knows there's no threat of engage. And they just keep pulling them back here because they're winning around the other areas of the map.
Splice is going to contest that dragon in this area of the map. Samsung back away. But gentlemen, looking at Samsung Galaxy, the analyst desk was alluding to those different versions of the team. You know, the regular season versus the playoffs and then regional qualifiers. We're 15 minutes in. Where do you think they're landing? Because there was questions about which Samsung would show up, especially considering they have Wraith instead of Core JJ as well.
To me, they're actually landing more towards their regular season form. They're not picking the very quick initiators, and they're generally playing smart. They're slowly building their advantage. They have a large amount of teamfight damage, and I feel like they're in pretty good control.
And honestly, they're just punishing Splice's mistakes. I think that's the difference. They've been very reactive in a lot of these plays, but when Splice do overstep, stick their hand in that cookie jar, they do slap it away relatively quickly. This is what we're used to seeing out of Samsung.
That's accrued them, what, nearly a 3,000 gold lead, 2 towers to 0, item advantages in nearly every single lane. First big ticket item starting to trickle through on the Samsung Galaxy side. As Rula's a couple hundred gold away from completing maybe that Iceborne Gauntlet I'm anticipating next. But as it stands, Samsung, happy, content, play the control game. Potential dive up top, let's take a look.
Yep, missed his Q. That is pretty much all of Pled's damage threat in lane. Still no magic resist, so he loses half of his health for that.
And really smart adaptation out of Kyubey here, because he has gone double flat penetration after seeing that the Kled wasn't going towards it. Now Mickey's in trouble.
Oh, another great Aqua Prison. Wraith really locking down Mickey. The tower's going to go down shortly. Ambition threatening an engage as Cobby is waiting for support. Here comes Wonder with the charge. Turn their attention to Ambition. Good tidal wave. Will cut off the team fight. Wraith is locked up. And whoa, the Super Mega Death Rocket takes down Ambition. A flash forward. Sengkooks has got the poison damage. And he's ruling.
Sengkooks.
Ruler. Sengkooks turns his attention to Kyubey. Kyubey's got the flame spitter and the overheat, though. It ends up being a 3-for-2. As on the back line, Splice lost a couple.
Yeah, but it looked like in desperation engage, they actually end up getting more kills then deaths for this when they lose lane pressure and maybe give up the turret, but that worked out far better than I expected it to.
And
do
as far as how a team fight goes, Sengkooks just throws down the gauntlet and charges three separate people to pretty much 1v1s, loses out on the last, but they're going for another play.
Well, Wonder's used the teleport to come in. Bear on a rope, doesn't connect, and all of a sudden Wonder's got no support. Cobby's too far away. Wonder's knocked up. Skull gets popped. Rocket pistol into a gobbledygook. Mickey's running away with Wonder. Saves his life, but teleports, flashes, a lot involved for that.
That is just another overreach from this Splice lineup. I mean, the game isn't that dire yet. They're just trying to go for these desperation teleport plays, and Wonder not able to hit the skill shots you would normally expect out of him.
I agree. He is playing a little bit strange when you're basing it off of his regular season form, maybe giving in to the pressure a little bit, or just playing against a team that is incredibly good at punishing his mistakes. Let's not forget that even though people were expecting KT to come to the World Championship, Samsung was very clearly just one step below them and still one of the better teams in Korea. But this Engage itself, Wonder comes in half health.
Yeah, he honestly engages onto Ambition in the end because of good play from the rest of the team. And it is Senghooks who single-handedly saves this team fight, flashing forward, challenging Ruler as the rest of his team is routed.
Specifically landing that one Q on Ezreal before he was able to pick up the double kill really allowed him to burst the damage in. Otherwise, that fight, I think, is a disaster. But one thing I do have to touch on here is the gold lead is actually extending for Samsung because they have very good wave pressure and they're consistently able to pick up the majority of the CS. And then Crown, the most hyped player on Samsung in all of the chaos, is the one playing with the most level head and becoming the most fit. 4-0 with the Rylai's, very strong.
A lot of damage. Mega Death Rocket is available. Tidal Wave comes out from the back. Samsung Galaxy in trouble.
Yeah.
Galadriel damage, flash away from the Rocket. Ruler and Crown, they've got the AoE. Wonder's getting tanked down, gonna get that passive popped. Mickey forced to use the Grey Help. True Shot Barrage has already been used. Mickey goes down. Crown flashed for that one. Manages to get himself a shot, and Trashy still being chased out. Equalizer is available for Qvay and Splice. They get a one for one, but they're forced to run away.
And you can see how much control is in this team composition. The Rylai's Crystal Scepter out of Crown, the Iceborne Gauntlet out of Ruler. When the team fight goes bad, they're just able to turn on a dime and continue to chase. And Splice, unfortunately, don't have the tools to get out of the team fight once they're in.
Agree with that. And I also have to commend the Summoner Spell Discipline out of Crown here. That's one thing that you really notice out of the very best mid laners is how they always get extreme value out of their summoner spells. He waited till just the right moment, flashed in, it's exactly what he needed, saved his ghost, and he's still just going to be a force to be reckoned with.
And his target selection is beautiful. I mean, he flashes in, cues the target, knows the maximum damage, gets that kill, and actually slows another member simultaneously. Because now Senkooks wants to try and kill him. He is out of mana.
Well, got a tower to fall back to because Splice have not taken any. 20 minutes into the game, it's a 6,000 gold deficit, and Splice have chased multiple losses, multiple plays that were just overeager, borderline desperate, and it's now up to Splice to contain Samsung Galaxy.
And when you bring a Jinx and a Cassiopeia into a team composition, you can afford to be playing much more disciplined than what this Splice lineup is right now. I mean, the scaling is technically still on your side.
Yeah, exactly. And when you're playing the Cassiopeia and the Jinx, you're expecting to have a little bit more setup with your teamfight. That is your prototypical backline damage threat. And then you would want the rest of the team composition built around tanks and peeling. But they have this weird mix, as we mentioned beforehand. They have the Kled in the top lane who's trying to all-initiate. The Tahm Kench would be their only front line, but you kind of need him to peel. So how exactly is Splice supposed to be setting up standard teamfights? Because their composition doesn't necessarily allow it. The very least is they have to play counter-engage and hope Samsung runs them a little bit.
Yeah, this is what in the LPL is just called a long-arm team comp, as you see that they're actually collapsing on Wonder.
Yeah, Wonder's in trouble. Flashed away, still gets caught out, sidesteps the Aqua Prison. Skull comes up, Chaos Storm gonna run him down. Tidal Wave holds him in place. Yes, Samsung used a lot for that. Ruler may be the victim. Summoner heal used, traded back and forth. Gobbled up by Mickey, spit out for the kill. But that's gonna be potentially a tower. No, Samsung, they've broken away from the bottom lane. It ends up being one-for-one trades.
Yeah, they respect the Baron. They leave Ambition there to try and clear out the turret. And honestly, even though that's a one-for-one, priority of the map still goes over to Samsung. And the problem is that Splice, they only have Kled to engage, and then everyone on Samsung's team comp excels at keeping and dealing damage from a very long distance, so it's incredibly hard to execute.
Yeah, especially with the lead that Samsung have accrued for themselves.
You know,
we were looking at expectations for this game, and the question marks around Samsung Galaxy and how they perform. And this is just a really good punish, once again, on Wonder being out of position.
Yeah, Wonder flashes early. He tries to sidestep as best as he can with the Nami bubble, but the Rylai's Crystal Scepter, as well as the Nami for Chase, is just inescapable. But this is also a little bit inexcusable for Ruler. He shifted in without flash, knowing three of his teammates were elsewhere. So that is a very poor play by the young AD carry on Samsung.
Yeah, it means that they can't pick off all that many objectives from the rest of the map play. However, one more time, they've finally got two wards out for Wonder, but they're still not warding any of the path into the jungle. And you can see that Samsung's pinged it out again. They just know that they can continue to go bottom lane because, unfortunately, Splice haven't been able to control their own jungle at this stage of the game.
We'll find out how Splice can find any control whatsoever. Take a look at those items. Rylai's plus needlessly large rod. Perfect hex core for Crown at 6-0-1. It's going to be a very, 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 very long time before anybody in Splice can compete with him and try to survive that damage, because he's got it for days.
Yep, and like we've been talking about, they're a difficult team to engage on, and Splice doesn't necessarily have the tools to do so. Wonder can jump in, Ruler and Crown can kite him back, Cubey can then lay down an equalizer on the rest of the back line. And one thing I do have to say about Crown's Victor is his gravity field placements are actually the best I've seen as far as his ability to control zones. So it's so telegraphed when Kled jumps in, just putting a gravity field right behind him gives you the time to kill Wonder as well. I think they're set up from a compositional standpoint, and also they have the right player on the Victor.
Oh, good sidestep again. That's the second time this game
has
gone
nice.
Away. Equalizer comes out, Senkaks flashes for the kill. How much will this hurt him later? We'll get one. Keeps throwing out those Twin Fangs, but now he's caught out. Ghost was used, Flash was used. Oh, Abyssal Voyage is coming in for Mickey. He wants to buy time.
He's
delivered Trashy. Trashy's been jumped on by Wraith. The fight gets broken out. Gravity Field pulls Mickey back.
What are they
jumped Crown. Wonder's gone out sideways. Cobby's been soloed out by Ruler. This is messy. Shut down onto Crown. Gigantic gold swing. Wonder's looking forward. Bear on a rope. Locks Wraith. Pulls him back. Wonder gets popped from Skull. Ruler's looking for a kill into Cobby. He's got blue buff. He's got skill shots for days. And Senkaks is looking to run down Ambition, gets a very good poison. Miasma, Twin Fang's gonna be needed. Sidesteps another, the fangs come out, and Senkak sinks it in. It's a 4-for-1.
Keep it going, next challenger.
I don't have enough air if it does. Senkak continues to slither away, throws out the poison. That's gonna slow Cubey down. He's got no equalizer. My God, Wonder's teleporting in. He's looking for more. Iceborne Gauntlet. Catches Ruler, pulls him backwards. Skull gets popped. Rocket Pistol's gonna get needed. Cubey goes golden, roasts Senkak, turns him into a pair of shoes. A new challenger appears. Cobby's looking for more. Flash away. Mickey saves Cobby, eats him up, devours, runs away. It's done. The fight is over.
Welcome to the League of Legends World Championship right now. What is going on in this game? It had been a controlled game for Samsung up until this point, until total chaos erupts. Now it's 4,000 gold spot!
And you have to compliment Senkaks one more time. This young mid laner goes top lane, challenges him to the duel, and this is why Tahm Kench is such a crucial pick for the team. They get the rest of their members up there, and they're able to swing the entirety of the game.
Yeah, I mean, I still feel like Samsung is in control. They have a 7-kill Victor who just completed the loot Zekko. They're up 5,000 gold, but that fight, I think I should call it, for the minute and a half that just happened, makes you know that anything is possible in this game. The fact that Senkaks is actually really, really strong on the Cassiopeia, this is about 40 seconds into the fight already, it's the second half of it, landing pretty much all of his skill shots early on and juking incredibly well, especially what happened in the early solo kill for Rumble, and then it just keeps going spot.
And one thing you have to say about Cassiopeia at this point of the game, she's pretty much unrivaled in terms of maximum damage per second if you can hit the skill shots. And Senkaks showed that he can do just that. You can see still chasing in. Wonder joined again. I think this was maybe a little bit too much, but I'm not entirely sure right now because they just continued to rack up some kills.
Yeah, the zone used by Cubey at the end there was pretty nice to be able to finish off the Cassiopeia. But here, the final auto, I believe, follows through from the Jinx as he's getting devoured by the Tahm Kench, which is enough to keep him safe from Ruler. If they're able to kill Crown like they did in that fight, because Crown thought he had a free kill lined up before Mickey X came in with Trashy, which, by the way, looked insane. I can't believe Trashy and Mickey just decided to jump in the middle of Samsung. If they can get Crown like that, Splice has a chance.
Crown 7-1-1, 280 CS. Senkaks 7-3-3, 225. Cobby on that Jinx 3-1-5. So a lot of the carries on Splice getting powered up. Wonder's looking for Ruler. Arcane Shift's already been used. Baron of Rope's gonna pull him backwards, but Wonder's eaten more than he can chew. Super Mega Death Rocket does not kill Ruler. The Ebb and Flow heal comes out from Wraith and Splice. They manage to force him away, but they don't get anything more.
But both teams millimeters away from pretty much disastrous mistakes. Pick there for Kobe would have meant that he was excited, would have been able to chase down through that turret potentially. Wonder at the same time, he's just going so deep with these charges, really disrespecting the damage that's coming out of Ruler as well as Crown.
You can kind of see what the overall plan is for the team composition though, because we talk about how they don't really have standard fight lines and they can't set up standard fights. But when Wonder jumps in there, it looks like with the Titanic Hydra, he has a pretty good amount of burst. They then Graves ult and Jinx ult, and they hope that kills someone. It nearly killed Ruler there. I think it could kill Crown because he doesn't have the Iceborne Gauntlet, and if they get a little poke on, that's pretty much what Samsung has to rely on, is that exact engage combination, but it actually getting kills.
Find out if Splice can do it, because we're approaching 30 minutes, and that gold lead, less and less substantial. Less and less relevant as the percentage advantage goes down. And I think more importantly for Splice, Cassiopeia and Jinx are starting to scale up. They've got gold, they've got kills. They just need to stay alive. That's what Europe and Splice needs.
And the danger of running these compositions is the fact that Ambition is a solo tank. And he can only tank up maybe Senkuks or Kobe, which means that he doesn't have to go towards the Last Whisper. You can just go double Zeal item, you can get your Maw in there, gives you a little bit more tankiness versus Crown. And late game, this Jinx is going to be ripping through the damage dealers at such incredible range with that rocket launcher that it's going to be hard, even for such a good comp like Samsung, to keep her at length.
I think if this game extends, to your point, the game can still be incredibly swingy because the Victor and the Jinx can kind of one-shot each other in that sense, and he's trying to keep people at arm's length. It is getting more and more tense, though, after that two-minute fight we had at the top lane some time ago.
Down in the bottom lane, Wonder's split pushing. Teleport is available for him. Should be able to get a lot of damage onto that outer tower. Splice still only taking one tower. And we mentioned the win-loss records earlier. Splice, pretty good from behind. Actually a positive win-loss ratio, whereas Samsung Galaxy, incredibly good with a lead. So unbreakable object versus an immovable object, you know, one of them is gonna break. Oh, Ambition, a little bit cheeky. Teleport comes out, here comes Crown. Teleport will complete, Mickey is left for dead on the front line. Wonder's teleported on the back, the Super Mega Death Rocket goes out. This is bad for Splice. Trashy goes down, the damage keeps climbing, and while Senkuks is doing his best, he simply can't burn through enough. Senkuks goes down, and it's a 2-0 in favor of Samsung.
And Kuve's equalizer in that team fight ripped through the entirety of Splice. I mean, there was just nowhere they could move. Fortin's off pretty much half the team fight, and this is going to lead to a Baron.
Yeah, fighting in the jungle, Kuve flexes his muscles as far as being a mage player is concerned. Crown had very little to do with that success, and Splice looks crazy. They're going in without their damage dealers.
Wonder's gone all the way in. Mickey was caught in the gravity field. That's two more kills donated to Samsung Galaxy.
Completely unnecessary right there, but it's the icing on the cake for Samsung. We're 30 minutes in. They give up two kills, which will just extend their death timers. And what is Samsung going to get about that? I'm actually very surprised they recalled. They could have taken the mid lane inhibitor pretty easily off of that.
They certainly could, but if they didn't feel like they could end the game, Infernal Drake is respawning as we take a look one more time. I mean, Senkuks is just running blind, no vision at all. Flash had to be burnt, flash out of Kobe, and then in comes the teleport and the equalizer.
Yep, because Senkuks burned his flash, Kuve just completely shuts him down. They push him into a corner. Ruler then shifts in, actually takes a bunch of damage from beforehand, so you can see the damage potential of him. But
Good! Fishy business for sure. Wraith gets the Aqua Prison. Now Mickey's being run down. Chaos Storm is out. Siphon Power, a double kill for Wraith. Look, he started the play. He deserves the goodies.
Yeah, Bloodthirsty support coming through there. Wraith is able to pick up two, and now Samsung just looks like they're rolling through Splice. 10,000 gold lead, and they're going to push into the base.
Pick after pick. I feel like it got a little bit chaotic for Samsung in the mid-game right there, but now they seem to be back in control, pushing for some inhibitors, maybe the game.
25-second death timer for Senkuks, who's one of the biggest damage dealers for Splice. Inhibitor will fall. Baron is still up for another 2 minutes. It's already a 5,000 gold Baron power play, which is phenomenal. And now Cobby with the Hurricane trying to do work, trying to wave clear. Inhibitor number two will fall. Samsung Galaxy moments away from picking up their first win at Worlds.
But once again, they are a disciplined team. They're willing to back away. They're jockeying for position around the map, just going to look to push in all three lanes, get the super creeps really rolling up. I mean, we've seen some weird and wonderful things today, so I don't blame them for playing this one quite slow.
Absolutely, and I think we've even seen some weird and wonderful things in this game alone. I think there's a lot of just getting used to playing on the world stage after having such a long hiatus from stage game. These guys have scrimmed hundreds of times since the last time they played on stage, and it's leading to some loopy things happening on stage, I feel like. But Samsung now, with Baron buff, two inhibitors down, going for number three.
Well, it should be relatively simple. Equalizer comes out, as well as the Tidal Wave. Cobby gets caught out. throws down Hex Drinker shield, actually, is popped rather. Wonder then jumps forward looking for Cuvée. Senkex is on the front line. Oh. Chaos Storm's gonna burn him down, not before Ruler takes him out. Ruler's going forward to the Arcane Shift. Wonder's caught out. Baron of Rope's not gonna save his life as Wraith is trying to run down Mickey on the back line. It's a fish versus a catfish, and it's gonna end up being Wraith that will win it. Another kill for Ruler. Samsung Galaxy with a monumental lead. Take down the Nexus turrets, take down the Nexus, and Samsung Galaxy pick up their first win of Worlds 2016.
Crown right at the end proves that he doesn't care about being a KDA player right now. 9 kills, 2 deaths, 7 assists. Rise to the laser at the very end. It was a bit of a messy game from Samsung, but I think they'll take their first win on the world stage here in 2016.
Yeah, and you have to say, you know, some of their players are younger and they got sucked in a little bit to these scrappy team fights that Splash were looking for. You understood why Splash wanted to go for them. That's your window back into a game like this. However, Samsung, in the end, good enough to be able to repel, slow the tempo back down and win the game.
Do you think it's fair to say the expectations and some of the questions we had around the teams turned out relatively true? Spice is weak early game, Samsung showing a level of control, you know, Wraith's mechanical prowess, all of these things that we kind of anticipated proved out in this game.
Yeah, I think Wraith's Victor was very strong. I think Samsung went back to the way they were, Crown's Victor, I think Samsung also went back to the way they were playing with Wraith. The thing that didn't go to expectations, I feel like, was the desperation with which Spice played, because they had been in so many similar situations in the European LCS with small deficits and handled it much better than I feel like they did in this game.
Yeah, I completely agree. The other thing I would say about Splash, and maybe a bit of shining light, is that Senkuk's had a pretty good laning phase this game against an opponent that is very well known for his laning prowess, especially on something like Victor. So maybe a strength in an area we didn't expect, but a lot of late game execution flaws for Splice here.
How on earth do the rest of the teams in the group now look at Samsung Galaxy? You have these expectations about CoreJJ, you have these expectations about Wraith. You see them show up in this game and preparing, knowing they've got a sub that they could pull in at any moment. Does this give